With the holiday season upon us, families everywhere are looking for extra attention, posting about memories and good cheer on Facebook. In this, the Duggars are certainly no exception, though their fans' attention to detail is quite exceptional, and may have uncovered the conspiracy. Not the fact that they sing Happy Birthday to Jesus instead of trimming a tree, although that could be discussion worthy another time. No, a throwback photo they shared of some of Jim Bob and Michelle Duggar's younger daughters was what whipped fans into a frenzy. The Inquisitor noted Thursday that the picture, below, shows the girls in Christmas dresses with one of their little brothers behind them. Cute, right? Obviously. Innocent, right? Mostly. Duggar internet detectives quickly realized that this was the year Josh was away at his Christian-oriented sex rehab hard labor camp. You know, the place in Illinois he was shipped off to after he was exposed as a child molester, adulterer and porn addict back in 2015. Just a coincidence? Much ado about nothing? Very possibly, but first, some background. Reformers Unanimous, the Christian rehab center where Josh, now 29, addressed his myriad sexual problems, was always controversial. Those familiar with RU say it that their staff has no actual psychologists, calling it another case of the Duggars handling things in-house. In any case, Josh was allegedly sequestered there for months, while his wife Anna moved in with her in-laws at their Arkansas compound. The Inquisitor notes that their four children shared the room as the younger Duggar daughters and the older unmarried girls at this time. Which brings us to the photo, taken around Christmas of that year, and which conveniently crops out the head of the adult male in the back. Anna and Josh Duggar, Bible launch event in DC. Now, we can't prove who that is. Maybe it's Josh Duggar, maybe it's not. But that's not the only reason some fans are wondering whether he attended rehab at all. Earlier reports indicated that Josh, now a father of five, left for at least some time during his extended stay in the Illinois facility. Most legitimate rehab facilities have strict policies determining when people can and cannot leave the premises, so that's already suspicious. Moreover, the Duggar family specifically stated that year that Josh could not leave Reformers Unanimous until his treatment was completed. Since he couldn't leave, allegedly, Anna Duggar would be visiting him regularly there. We were led to believe that this happened. All of this could be conjecture, but given the way the family handles matters like this, the whole thing was always shrouded in mystery. Is it a stretch to assume that he was simply sequestered in some sort of home confinement while the family concocted this rehab ruse? Probably. But would you really put it past a man, Jim Bob, who was clearly reluctant to address Josh's sexual issues head-on for years? In any case, it raises a series of questions. If Josh Duggar wasn't actually in rehab, where the heck was he? If he was there, did he just leave and come back whenever he chose? If that's the case, what kind of facility is this, and did he get any real help while he was there? Can you trust anything this family claims?